Hello everyone, Ranjita here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am here with a very simple and basic tutorial. Today I am going to show you how you can make easy bookmarks by painting some loose watercolor florals over it. This is a very beginner friendly project. Even if you haven't tried painting with watercolors anytime, I think this would be a go-to project for you. So let's begin with the supplies. So here I'm taking a 300 GSM watercolor paper and I'm taping it down onto my board. I'm also having some clear water, some basic brushes in different sizes, and I have some watercolors. Today for this project I'm using this 42 shades watercolor palette. You can use whatever is handy for you. Moving on to the first bookmark, I'm making three petals with a red shade here. I'm not very keen on making the perfect flower here, but as you can see, I'm just painting loose florals here. I'm making three petals here just to make it look like the flower is looking away from me. In all the examples today, I'm trying to paint generic flowers. I'm not trying to represent any particular kind of flower, and I'm not trying to recreate any of them. So what I'm doing is I'm taking the color of my choice, whatever my mind takes me today, and I'm just painting loose floral shapes here. As I told you before, this is a very beginner friendly tutorial. Even kids can try this. So here I'm just brushing three loose petals, and once my watercolor is dry, I'm going with a fine liner tip pen here, and I'm just doodling an outline of the flower here. Make sure your pen has waterproof ink, or you just wait for the paint to dry completely, otherwise your ink will bleed and it will spoil the entire painting that you have done here. If you do not have a waterproof ink pen or an archival ink pen, make sure you finish all your watercoloring beforehand, before you doodle with pen over it. This will prevent any bleeding of the ink. So here, as you can see, I didn't like the background to be too white, so I'm just loosely watercoloring it with a shade of yellow here, just to add some interest to my background. Since my ink was archival ink, it is not bleeding here, so that is why I told you, if you want to use a pen without a waterproof ink, make sure you finish all your watercoloring beforehand. And to add some more interest to the background, I am stamping this text stamp here randomly all over my background. This has brought in so much more interest to my bookmark. That's it, my first bookmark is almost done. Now it is the reveal time. I'm peeling off my tape here. Very easy bookmark. It hardly took me 10 minutes to finish this bookmark. Now let's go ahead with the second bookmark. I'm doing a similar pattern here also, but I'm making smaller flowers, and I'm just making random shapes here. For some of the flowers I'm making two petals, some of them I'm making a single petal to make it look like a bud. And for some of them I'm having three. So there is no right way or wrong way of doing it. I'm just trying to paint loose watercolor florals here. I'm a self-taught artist, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate some techniques which I evolved in the early days of my experiments with watercolors. So these are very beginner friendly examples that I'm going to show you in this video. As you can see here, first I've painted some loose watercolor florals with a lighter shade of pink, and when my first layer was dry, I went ahead with another darker shade of red, and I'm going over these flowers. This will add some more interest, and to fill in the gaps I'm just adding some more smaller petal like shapes to fill in my bookmark. This is entirely your choice. You can choose your design, you can make a bunch of flowers, or you can make just a flower. And to complete my florals here, I'm adding some thin lines here to look like branches. If you're not very confident with drawing such thin strokes, you can go ahead and use a fine liner pen in green color to add in your branches. just like I did in the first bookmark. I didn't want my background to be too white, so I'm adding a shade of blue, very dilute watercolor here. I just wanted to add a hint of color, but I didn't want my background to be dominated over my foreground here. So I'm just painting some blue shade here. As I come nearer to the flowers, I'm adding a little darker shade, and in the background I'm having a lighter shade of blue. For the background, I am stamping these subtle dots with archival ink just to bring in so much more interest to my bookmark, and also to cover up the little flaws if at all they were there. Here you can see this is my bookmark. So the second bookmark is also done. Very quick and easy bookmark. So let's move ahead and do the third bookmark here. For the third one, what I'm doing is I'm taking a thin round brush and I'm painting plain water first onto my bookmark in the shape of a flower. So this flower is having very thin petals only on the lower side, so it again looks like a drooping flower. So first I've painted with water just to control the flow of my watercolor first, so you can consider it as a wet on wet technique. So first I've painted it with plain water, and then I've added some shade of yellow onto it. I'm going ahead and finishing up the leaves and the stem of the flower. I'm making sure each layer dries before I go ahead with another color. If you want to blend in your colors, you can play around with your colors while your underlying layer is still wet. But I prefer to let it dry for this flower. So as you can see here, I'm adding a little brown here to the center of the flower, and then I'm taking a plain wet brush and I'm pulling the brown a little so that it blends in with the flower. In between, I'm trying to dry my watercolor with a dryer here, and then I'm going with my fine liner pen. This is from Pigma Micron, and I'm doodling the borders here. This adds a lot of interest, and I like this particular style of loose watercolors wherein I just paint the flowers first and then go over the borders with a fine tip marker. I'm adding some subtle details with my fine tip pen, and at the last, if I need to add some more color, I'm just taking a light wet brush and pulling the watercolor to bring in more life and to fill in the other gaps here and there. Like always, I'm just lightly painting my background. I do not like the entirely white background for this. So I'm just bringing a light shade of blue all over my background. For the background, I'm stamping this border stamp randomly all over the background. This really enhanced the look of the bookmark, and it took it to another level, I believe. And this one happened to be one of my favorite bookmarks. So here you can see the finished bookmark. And to add some more interest, I'm taking a white gel pen and I'm randomly adding highlights all over the flower. Adding such fine details do not take much of your time, but they bring in so much more interest to your finished project. So let's move ahead and make the fourth bookmark. For the fourth bookmark, I'm painting some loose roses here. First, I'm taking a watercolor, a light shade of pink here, and I'm painting in circular motion, but I'm just filling in with blobs of color here. And then I'm letting this layer dry, and then I'm taking a darker shade of red here and then going in intermittent circular motions here. If you want to clearly know how I paint roses, Then I have another video showing different watercolors. I've made another video showing a set of four bookmarks in which I have painted loose watercolor florals as well. So go ahead and check that video. So as you can see here, first I've done a layer of light red or pink here, and then I am going with a darker pink with a less diluted paint here, and I am going over it. These make it look like unfinished loose roses here, finishing off my roses with adding the stems and some more leaves with green paint. I'm adding a light yellow wash for my background just to bring in some more interest and not to leave it completely white. Once my paint is completely dry, I'm going ahead with my fine tip marker and adding some fine details. Once I'm done with the black marker, I will go ahead and take my white gel pen and will add some more details to these roses to add in a little more interest to my paintings. Adding some interest with my background stamp as well. So as you can see here, all my bookmarks follow a similar pattern, but I've been demonstrating just different types of generic flowers here. So all I'm doing is painting some loose florals and adding fine details with a black tip marker, and then I'm painting my background and stamping some interest onto my background. So this finishes the fourth bookmark. I hope you like the series of watercolor bookmarks here. You can see the close-up images of the finished bookmarks. I really liked how they turned out and how vibrant these colors are, and also it was very, very simple and quick to finish these bookmarks. I hope you liked this video of mine and I was of some inspiration to you. In case if you like this video and if you're going to try some of these bookmarks, make sure you share them with me on my social media. I would love to see what you do. That's it for now. I will come back with another video and a new craft inspiration. Until then, thank you so much for stopping by, and also if you haven't done it yet, please consider subscribing to my channel and also do follow me on my social media. The links are given in the description box below. Thank you.